What was Darwin's problem with brown owl? And why did he not describe it?
Now, clearly, if one makes a joke about Girl Guides here, like he was traumatised during a period in the Girl Guides...
Before...
Help me now.
We even predicted your mistake, because I think brown owl brownies.
Yeah.
Yeah. He must have died before...
Before the brownies existed, exactly.
Yeah. He probably ate it or something.
Ah!
So he ate brown owls, you're saying?
Well, actually, he didn't, because he described it as indescribable, which is why he didn't describe the brown owl. Well, actually, as food, he meant, because Charles Darwin, one of the greatest scientists, one of the greatest men, really, of any age, was considered a very dim pupil and couldn't spell and was terrible at arithmetic and went to Cambridge. The only subject his father thought was fit for him was divinity. And he spent his time chasing rats and shooting and looking at animals and eating strange animals. He was a member of the Gourmet Society, or the Gluttons, as it was known at Cambridge, and their aim in life was to eat as many rare and peculiar animals, like bitterns and hawks. But brown owl, they... didn't like it at all. And all the others became bishops and archdeacons.
Does this still exist, this club?
Exists. Stephen's the president of it.
Yeah, otherwise you write me around for fox on crib.
Right. I think panda. That's the... Oh, it's lovely.
I've got a book at home. It's equivalent to the Collins Book of Birds from 1850. And after describing each bird, at the end it will say, for instance, a buzzard, tastes a little bit milder than a golden eagle.
Yes.
But still quite palatable.
Does it have a wine recommendation at the bottom? You suggest a Chablis or a New World Merlot?
Do you know what you should drink with the beating heart of a cobra? And this is a dish in China where you get a cobra and it's brought to the table alive. They then slice it open, rip the heart out, and it's beating on the plate there. You have to chase it around the plate, I suppose. And then you drink the blood of the snake as the wine.
Actually, I order the lasagna.
What's the most disgusting thing you've ever eaten, Alan?
Earwax.
Your own? It was your own, that's
all. It's really horrible.
Bitter.
I mean, if just a tiny bit on the end of your fingers.
Sweet and sour.
Imagine if you had to have a sandwich of it.
Oh!
Oh, no, no. Really, like a block of it.
Ah! Anyway, a phylum feast is held on the 12th of February every year by zoologists and biologists, in which they try and eat as many different species as possible, in honour of Charles Darwin, whose birthday that was.